Good afternoon, YouTube. So I've been going through my Grizzly G4000 lathe, and I've been replacing all the original set screws. So I put some, I think these are M5 by 0.8 millimeter pitch, and so I put some regular socket head cap screws on there in place of the internal head set screws. All of those original ones were stripped out, so I've replace those, and then I've also replaced the ones here on the side that adjust the gibs. I showed you this a couple weeks ago where I replaced this one here, but I wanted to show you one other, or actually two other set screws. I actually replaced these. I showed you the two set screws that thread in here, but you can see how this bushing has pushed out. I was doing some drilling, and I guess the force of the drill bit pushing back started pushing this bushing out. I showed you in the earlier video, there's this cast iron part of the tailstock, and then there's this machined steel part in the middle, this bushing, and then there's two half holes drilled in. They're half in the cast iron and then half in the steel part, and you run those two set screws in, and that's what gives you the thrust force. The problem is the threads in this cast iron part are pretty much gone. So let me pull this thing apart and I'll show you what's going on here. But you can see how that thrust bushing has pushed its way out. That used to be flush. You can buy this replacement part from Grizzly. It's about $85. Anyway, my plan is I'm going to pull these out, tap this back in, and then I'm going to put one screw in to locate everything. Then I'm going to drill and tap this one. Yeah, so I got this seated back down in there, and you can see how loose that set screw is there. It just wiggles. In fact, this one here is, I think, completely stripped out. You can shove the screw in all the way to the bottom without turning it. Yeah, these things are pretty well shot, so I'm going to leave this screw in, and then I'm going to come over here and re-tap this hole. So I got the tailstock in my drill press and lined up a number 3 bit here. Cleaned out the hole down to the bottom. Okay, one down, one to go. I took this hole here after I drilled it, and then I ran the 3 taps down there and blew out all the cast iron chips in between. So you got your taper, plug, and bottoming tap. So this last tap there will go clear to the bottom with threads. It doesn't have any taper to it. And then I ran a 1/4 28 by 3/8 set screw down there. Used to be an M5 by 10, so you're about the same length and just a little bit bigger. Okay, we got the last pass with the bottoming tap there. I'll spin that one out. Yeah, you gotta dump all of the shavings. There's a lot of cast iron powder, so every time you run the tap in, you gotta take it out of the vise and then dump this out. But you can see we've got some nice clean threads in there now, all the way around. And then I put a little dimple on the housing and on the bushing, so I know which way they line up. So in the future, I don't have to do my trial and error fit. I don't know why they didn't put something like that on in the beginning. Okay, there we go. I think we're all back in business. Might have to adjust this a little more. It's a little bit tight right there, but I think that's going to hold. The set screws went in there really solid and snugged right down. I put a little bit of anti-seize on the threads to try to keep from stripping the threads out. But yeah, this is a pretty good lathe. I mean, it's a real workhorse, and it's definitely earned its keep. I've had it, oh, probably 20 years now, and I've gone through, like, this is the second tailstock ram that I've had in there. Yeah, I've replaced this screw, changed the belts a couple of times. I did a video on that a while back. So yeah, you got to keep up with the maintenance on these things and have some of those parts on hand. But yeah, definitely worthwhile go through and replace all these set screws, because I don't know, they just seem to use really soft metal in the set screws. Okay, YouTube, just wanted to show you the repaired tailstock bushing, I guess that's a thrust bushing in there, is working okay. I'm drilling half inch hole in some aluminum. Looks like everything's working okay. I might need to loosen this up a bit. There's still a bit of tightness. But other than that, it's working pretty good. I've drilled a couple of these already, and I got a couple more to do, but this is what I was doing when that thing popped out of there. So I think the quarter 28 set screws are working just right. I used 3/8 inch long, and I think actually that's a little better. The existing holes were 10 millimeters deep, but I always had a problem with the very head of the set screw was sticking out just a little ways, and then it would drag on this hand wheel. So with a 3/8 set screw, it goes just below the surface, and then you get a nice smooth rotation there. I think it's just a little bit tight right now. I gotta loosen things up. I figure I'd run it for a while and see if it loosens up by itself, and then if it doesn't, I'll give it an adjustment. But yeah, I think we're back in business. So just wanted to show you the repair in action. Everything's working, so I think I'm good to go. So yeah, if you have any questions about that, post up in the comment section below, and I'll put some other lathe repair videos over here on the left side that you might be interested in. And as always, thanks for watching.